हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ सुजीत साली, लेक्चर इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, जैन पॉलिटेक्निक, बेलगाम। सो इन दिस वीडियो, दिस इज द वीडियो दैट इज फाइनल पार्ट ऑफ द थर्ड चैप्टर, दैट इज थर्मोडायनेमिक साइकिल। सो इन दिस वीडियो विल गो थ्रू टू टाइप्स ऑफ साइकिल, डीजल साइकिल एंड ड्यूल साइकिल। सो लेट्स गो थ्रू द फर्स्ट वन, दैट इज अ डीजल साइकिल। सो दिस डीजल साइकिल इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर साइकिल। सो दिस डीजल साइकिल वॉज इन्वेंटेड बाय inventor Rudolf Diesel in the year 1890. So hence the name it is given as Diesel cycle. So in this cycle we call it as constant pressure cycle because the heat addition, whatever the heat addition is there, it takes place during constant pressure. So here this cycle is explained by these two diagrams, PV and TS diagram. So here P is pressure, volume and temperature and entropy. So here you'll be having four types of processes: a compression process, an expansion process, a heat addition process and heat rejection process. So these four processes are combined to form a cycle. So this diesel cycle actually it resembles exactly your diesel engine. So whatever these processes are there, all those four processes taking place in your diesel engine. So that same cycle is being proposed here. So we'll just see the processes one by one. So the first one is the adiabatic compression. So once the air is supplied into the engine cylinder, that is piston cylinder arrangement, so once the air is sent, so that air has to be compressed. So the piston starts moving from TDC to BDC or from right side to the left side if it is in horizontal. So once it starts pushing the air, whatever the air is present, so what happens? The air starts compressing. So how the air is compressed? The air is compressed adiabatically. In the sense, during this compression, no heat is added or no heat is rejected. Hence we call it as an adiabatic compression. Simultaneously you can see the TS diagram. So here the temperature increases during this process from T1 to T2, that is from T1 to T2, and the entropy remains same because no heat is added or rejected during this process, hence entropy remains same. So the pressure, the air reaches at point 2, that is from pressure P1 to P2. So the volume decreases, the pressure increases and it reaches P2. So after the air has been compressed, so next process is to add the heat or the heat addition. So that is the second process, process 2 to 3, heat addition at constant pressure. So during this process what happens is the pressure of that air is kept constant and the heat is added to it. Hence we call it as constant pressure cycle, means heat addition is taking place at constant pressure. So during this process the pressure remains same, the volume slightly increases from V2 to V3. Same way here on TS diagram, the temperature increases from T2 to T3. Same way, the entropy from S2 to S3. So you can see that temperature T3, the temperature will be maximum in the whole cycle. Okay, the T3 temperature will be maximum in the whole cycle. So after the heat has been added to the gas, what happens? The gas has to expand. That is the third process, that is process 3 to 4, adiabatic expansion. So the air, once it absorbs it, it starts expanding adiabatically, means no heat is added or rejected during this expansion. So the pressure reduces from P3 to P4 and volume increases from V3 to V4. Same way here, the temperature reduces from T3 to T4, but the entropy remains same because no heat is added or rejected. So once it has been fully expanded, the heat has to be extracted from that gas. So that is the fourth process, that is 4 to 1, heat rejection at constant volume. So to that, whatever heat rejection process is there, the volume is kept constant. Hence we call it as heat rejection at constant volume. So during this process, the pressure reduces further and it reaches P1, that is 0.1. And same way, the temperature and entropy reduces to S1 and T1 simultaneously. So here what happens is, whatever your air was there, it has attended the initial condition. So whatever the beginning of the air, the condition had, the air had the condition, initial condition, that same condition has been attended here. So again the same air is used to repeat the cycle. So again all the four processes are completed, and again the same air is used again and again to repeat the cycle. So this is the diesel cycle. So all these processes, you can consider that all these processes are taking place exactly like whatever you have in your diesel engine. So once the air is sucked inside to the cylinder, the valve, whatever you have, inlet valve and exhaust valve, and the valves are closed, and then the piston starts compressing the air. That is nothing but your adiabatic compression. Once the piston compresses, the heat is added, means the fuel is supplied to the fuel inject through the fuel injector, and during that what happens, the burning takes place. That is nothing but the heat addition. During that heat addition, what whatever the pressure is there, that is remained constant. And after that, what happens is, once the heat is added, it has to expand. So that is what the adiabatic expansion. And finally, once it has fully expanded, the heat is ejected out of that gas. That is the fourth process, that is heat rejection at constant volume. So this cycle or this concept resembles the diesel engine. So next we'll go through the third, the final type of process or final type of cycle, what we call it as a dual cycle. So this dual cycle, actually it is a combination of, this dual cycle is a combination of petrol, that is Otto cycle, as well as diesel cycle. In the sense, the heat is added partially at constant volume and heat is added partially at constant pressure. So actually how that process takes place, we'll just see here. Same way, the same process explained by using PV and TS diagram. So you can see here, it has five processes. So earlier we had four processes, here we have a five process. Means the heat addition, the partial heat addition takes place during constant volume, and partial heat addition takes place during constant pressure. So we'll just go through these processes one by one. So we'll see the first process, that is adiabatic compression. Same way like earlier, the compression of the air or the gas takes place adiabatically, means no heat is added or rejected during this compression. So the pressure increases from P1 to P2 and volume reduces from V1 to V2. Same way on TS diagram, the temperature increases to T2, the entropy remains same, it doesn't change. So after the air has been compressed, so what, the heat has been added to that air. So during this first heat addition, the volume is kept constant. Okay, so that is volume is kept constant and heat is added. So during this, what happens, the pressure again further increases from P2 to P3, the volume remains same, and again the temperature increases from T2 to T3. So partially the heat is added during constant volume. Okay, so after that, again the heat is added at constant pressure, that is during the process 3 to 4. So here the volume was kept constant, so during 3 to 4 the pressure is kept constant and heat is added. So after that, what happens, again in TS diagram, if you see, the temperature further increases and reaches 0.4, that is T4. Here the pressure remains same, that is P3 is equal to P4. So here you can see either P3 or P4 will be the maximum pressure in the whole cycle. Same way here, at 0.4 the temperature T4 will be maximum in the whole cycle. So once the heat is added during constant volume and constant pressure, so whatever the air is there, it has to start expanding. So here from 4 to 5 is your adiabatic expansion process. So the air expands adiabatically, means no heat is added or rejected during this process. The pressure reduces to P5, as well as the your volume increases to V5. Same way, the temperature reduces to T5, and during this process the entropy remains constant, it doesn't change. So once it has been fully expanded, the heat has to be rejected. So that is what your process 5 to 1, heat rejection at constant volume. Finally, the volume is kept constant during the heat rejection, means during the heat removal from the air. So once the heat is removed, what happens, the pressure again further reduces and it reaches to P1. So this P1 and V1, volume V1, is nothing but your initial condition of the air. The initial, whatever the initial condition was there at the beginning of the cycle, that same condition has been attained. Same way here, the temperature reduces from T5 to T1. Same way, the entropy reduces from S5 to S1. So now all the initial condition have been met. Now again the same air is used and the cycle is repeated. So this is your dual cycle. So we call it dual cycle because partial heat addition at constant volume and partial heat addition at constant pressure. That's why it is a combination of two cycles, we call it as dual cycle. So this is regarding the chapter thermodynamic cycle. So in this we have covered the introduction to cycle, what do you mean by reversible and irreversible cycle, what are the assumptions made in these cycles, and then we have seen Carnot cycle, Otto cycle, diesel cycle and dual cycle explanations. So I just want to tell you that you keep on reading or you keep on going through these videos again and again, so that whatever the matter is there or the content is there that has been explained in these videos, so that you remember these contents for a longer period of time. Okay, so thank you.